From the hit Netflix TV show, this is Geralt of Rivia, The Witcher, basically, if you've seen the TV show. So, great looking figure, actually. Pretty cool in a lot of aspects. Some not so great. We'll do a quick comparison to the really classic kind of version that McFarlane have done from the game. And we'll just give you a look at it. And I'll also bring in a little bit of a horsey action. We'll explain that in a minute or two. But just to start off with, in terms of Geralt's height, he's just about 7 inches or 18 centimeters overall. So quite a tall figure. You can pre-order this at Dorkside Toys. Should be in stock with them any day. And there's a few other Witcher figures there as well that you can pick up from the range. So, packaging first of all, as we can see, Netflix logo, The Witcher, Geralt on the label there, and a bit of a kind of map on the side in the kind of background art, a little bit Lord of the Ringsy kind of vibe. And in the back, we just get a couple of pictures of Henry Cavill in outfit. Notice the kind of very silver aspect on the armor there. And there are a couple of versions. They've got one of them with the kind of the eyes, basically, he's taking one of the potions, if you know what I mean, when he's watched, if you've watched the show or played the game. But this is the more standard version, the common version, if you will. 22 moving parts. This one tends to be a little bit more expensive in some places, purely because of the fact that it's got some soft goods, and I think and there's a little Witcher logo up the top of the box, and I think it's because McFarlane are really feeling the pinch too in terms of prices. They've got to pay extra prices too. So just getting a quicker look at Geralt, we'll just scan around and get a look at that facial sculpt. As you can see, soft goods cape all the way down. It's actually a really nicely done cape. The facial sculpt is, from an angle, kind of like him. Not too shabby overall, but it's, again, decent cape all the way down. Comes with a figure stand as well, which, again, we should see. Yep, it's labelled The Witcher on there. Let me take this, in fact, before I do, let me just position this with... I've just reviewed the Dark Knight Returns Batman wave. And although this isn't Roach, the horse, it's kind of very similar, because literally all that you'll be getting for Roach is a different head and maybe a different saddle, it looks like. Other than that, all the components of the horse, and a slightly different tail, I think, as well, are essentially the same. The body, the legs, the thighs, that kind of stuff. So it's just nice to give it a scale and look at it. Let me even pop this off the figure stand and even just roughly, not spend too much time on it, pop this on horsey here. What I will do is stop this for 1 second. And we'll get a look at Geralt on the horse. I'm not going to spend too much time posing it, but it's not bad. It is not bad at all. In terms of, again, I could be here all day posing the damn thing, so I'm not going to spend too long. But, you know, in scale, looking good. It's not terrible. So if you've got the Dark Knight horse, then maybe you want to use this instead. If not, you can go and buy a Roach separately, and he's available too. Dorkside Toys. Link in the description below. So let's get horsey out of the way and get a look closer at Geralt overall. One key thing on the accessory front I really do like is the sword. If we have a look at that sword in more detail, you'll see just the gold on that shaft is really nice. It's a gorgeous sculpt, and again, all the detail on his sword is really nicely done. Can't go much closer, otherwise it won't. You can see all the little symbols beautifully picked up. They've made it so deep that the paint just really kind of picks up all those kind of details in there. On the flip side of the sword, again, we get a different little crest piece on that too. Beautiful, just really nice details on that, and again, all these little symbols going on. In terms of the cloak, again, as I said, it's like, yeah, it's good. It is definitely one of the better ones, and it actually works and sits and behaves. You get a couple of cords here you could tie. Honestly, I've not had time to faff around with it, and I don't know whether I will keep it on the figure, to be fair. So put that to the side, but it is a good looking cape. We've got his medallion there, looking pretty good too. And facial sculpt-wise, you know, there's a bit of Henry Cavill in there. There's also not Henry Cavill in there, but kind of from the side, I think it is. I think they've done a good job. I feel the hair should be a little bit more white than this grey. If we have a look even at the artwork for Henry on the back of that box. I mean, the man is almost albino. So, yeah, he's very, very white as opposed to the grey we have here. So there's quite a bit of a difference in terms of the paint overall. But let me just give you one other really quick close-up of that face just to see how well painted that is. I think what they have captured really well is not only the eyes, but the Henry Cavill dimple and the kind of stubble, that really nice. That's quite hard to do, to get that smudging of stubble going on. Henry Cavill looks like one of these dudes that literally shaves and then immediately has a 5 o'clock shadow. So it's nicely done. The neck is a little bit weirdly overpainted and kind of odd, but you don't really see it because the jawline just dominates. Here, as I said, it is kind of nicely done, but just to me a little bit too grey. All kind of sculpted and moulded nicely and then put on. It does create a kind of wig-like effect because it's a separate piece. So clearly they're going to use this face and this sculpt again for different models and versions, potentially. So yeah. One issue about the hair, though, I find, whilst it's quite kind of detailed at the back and looks the part, it's very much sculpted to fit a certain space. One is to allow, obviously, the sword and the sheath there, so there's a little bit of a kind of movement there. And this trailing piece of hair here, it's actually a bit of a pain in the ass, because what it does is, and I'll pull back here, it kind of limits you in terms of, and the whole mullet limits you in terms of posability, as you can see. You can kind of get it to the side, but then this little trail here just looks a little bit weird. So, yes, but no. You know what I mean. If you've bought any figures with kind of hair sculpted, it creates a kind of weird effect. So it kind of works, kind of doesn't. I think you're really kind of limited to sculpting. That's not terrible, it has to be said. That one looks a little bit better around there to the side, but ultimately it's really designed to kind of sit in the way it's been sculpted straight on in the figure. So it is what it is. Now, there's no real silver on this figure, which is kind of, again, if you recall when I was talking about the packaging, if we quickly go back and have a look, there is a lot of silver on his armor. Lots of tiny little pieces of silver. So the paint has been skipped here, I can understand, from a cost perspective. And there is quite a fair bit of paint on the figure overall, and the facial side of things. So it really could do with a little bit more kind of silvering up of these little speckled pieces on the armor. And I think that would have just really incredibly improved it. But I understand the cost perspective. Belts and buckles get a minimal splash of gold and buckles here going on, all the rest of it. Down to boots, again, nicely sculpted, everything is well done, there's no real issues at all. Bit of Geralt bottom. And we get this sword sheath here that still is half opened. McFarlane seemed to love or have to make sheaths kind of half open. I don't quite know why, if that's accurate to the show or not, but I tend to find a lot of the figures, as I reviewed Warhammer the other day, and just there's no cover to the sword sheath or the dagger sheath. So it's a little bit weird in that way. That looks like a plug on the back, I think. Is that a little plug that's holding that in there? Looks like it, just to kind of stabilise it against the back. But look, overall, pretty good. The sculpt is there. Some paint is there. There is some nice details in terms of the figure overall. But yeah, it's really going to be one to decide if you love the show or not. In terms of articulation, we talked about the head. It is on a ball joint, so you get a little bit more forward and backwards. But again, that rotation around there is hard. Underneath these shoulder pads, you will see it's got a kind of mini butterfly joint, as most figures tend to have these days. And then the ball joint, certainly on McFarlane, it's really just a ring for decoration more than anything. But it does give you a pretty reasonably good, considering he's got armour, swivel and rotational movement. He has a bicep swivel too, which is quite nicely done, actually. Kind of tucked in with the kind of protection on the armor. We've got a double joint at the elbows. You can see that pin tech going on there. And down to the wrists, it's got that weird McFarlane wrist situation going on. I'm not a fan, but there we go. No extra hands in the package. Both hands are just kind of gripping hands, which is fine. He does have a bit of an ab crunch, I believe, inside. Yeah, it's kind of, but you're not going to get any ab crunch going because this spongy armor all the way around acts like a kind of corset. and really makes it really difficult. So you can't really get that too much. It does have waist articulation though. Pegs up at the top of the legs, standard McFarlane stuff. You get a thigh swivel up at the top too. Double joints at the knees, you can see down there. I think we got a boot cut, have we? Do we have a boot cut? No. Looked like it does. No, it's too close to that knee joint. So there's no boot cut. But we do have those rocking ankles and little witcher toes and peckles because, of course, stand. So, look, it's quite a good figure. I'm really quite impressed. In terms of comparison to the original Geralt, I'm a big fan of the game version and all the kind of versions. And I believe Darkseid still has some of this original up in some of his flavours. I would highly recommend you get this figure, the Geralt. This one here, I'm pointing the sword at here and stabbing. Out of anything, just because it is only going to get up in money, just very much like any of their game figures. Doom, the Doom Marine, the original, pardon me, the original Doom Green Marine has just gone up for nutty money. So again, standard game figures are definitely ones to kind of, I wouldn't say invest, but buy at least and have them. This one, in terms of the show, I don't know, a little bit more hit and miss for some people. But I like it. I'm certainly a big fan of The Witcher show. And this Henry Cavill figure is by no means a disappointment at all. I think it's actually pretty solid. Will there be better as we go on? Could the facial sculpt be better in the paint? Yeah, marginally. But ultimately, solid figure. Highly recommend you go and get it. Again, link in the description to Darkseid. And if they've sold out, we'll put a link to eBay. But let us know what you think of this figure. We will see you for more coming up.